Hi friends, this is Mugundan Raghavan. Today we are going to see histograms with Python. Agenda of this video: first we will understand where histograms will be used. So it will be used for numerical data, interval, ratio, and estimate the probability distribution of a continuous variable, quantitative variable. And we saw what is numerical data already in the previous video. So it is interval and ratio will be the subtypes for numerical data, and it will be the continuous variable. And in x-axis we will have the data, and y-axis we will have the frequency. And like bar chart, we will have the values and its names. And bin is the main concept in histograms. So bin in histogram is the block that you use to combine the values before getting the frequency. So you can consider the real time bin usage. So bin will be having place to hold whatever the things we want to place, and it will be having different bins. So in our case, we will mention the bins. It is like a location where you will accumulate or save the all the details or combine the values before getting the frequency. So let's say you have three boxes and you have 20 chocolates. So in three boxes, whichever the number you want to put it into the different bins, you can put it, and you will have the different bins with your required values. The same way here, we are just combining the values in the bin. So that's all about the bin. So we will see in the practical code. And next one, the number of observation occupying in a given bin becomes the frequency of that bin. So as I told earlier example, so let's say in first bin you are placing 10 chocolates, so the frequency will be 10 for that bin. The second bin you are placing 3 chocolates, then it will be 3 of the second bin. So the frequency of the second bin will be 3. So it will be like that. Histograms are based on area, not height of the bars. In bar chart, we will measure the height of the each bar and we will decide how much quantity or how much value it has. But in histograms, we will measure based on the area. So for the given area, you will decide how much data are distributed. So in simple, area of the bar that indicates the frequency of occurrences for each bin. Any observation can occupy only one bin. So let's say you have multiple observations, so you can place it only in any one of the bin. You cannot place in the multiple bins. So this is the sample code. So first line will be import matplotlib pyplot as plt, as usual the normal statement for charts. And next one, marks. So here I am giving the list of marks. And next one, the straightforward formula or method, plt.hist. So it is stands for histogram, and I am passing the values marks, and we don't have the y values. Because since it's a histograms, we will have only the marks or the x values. Y will be the frequency. Now I am creating the bins. So bins will be like from 0 to 15 will be one bin. So whatever values comes under 0 to 15 will be placed in the first bin, and 15 to 50 will be the second bin. Whatever the values from our input will come under 15 to 50 will be placed in the second bin. And 50 to 100 will be the third interval. So the third bin will have the values range between the 50 and 100. And I'm just giving the R with relative width 0.8 so that we will have the gap between the individual bins. And next one, I'm giving the color and I'm giving the label as marks. So that's a simple straightforward. And after that, we will give the labels for X and Y, marks and frequency. And title of the total graph or chart will be mark analysis. And I'm adding the legend. So legend means it will show, if you have the different colors or bars, it will show what the color means. And next one, grid to see very good way. So we are just adding the line like plt.grid. So it will be true so that you will have the grid format in the output. And next one will be the plt show. So it will plot the graph entirely. So by seeing the example, you can understand. So if you consider 0 to 15, how many values in marks? So let's say 0 to 15, 10, 11, 12, That's all, three values. So you can see the frequency of that will be 3, first bin. Next one, 15 to 50. So it will be 25, 26, 27, 28, 50. 25, 26, 27, 28, 50. So it will be 4. Correct. So next one will be 50 to 100. So 50 to 100 will be 50, 60, 70, 80, 100. So 5 values. So based on that, the frequency will be generated. So by seeing this graph, we can tell which bin has more data or more frequency or how it got distributed. So it has further more parameters to be passed in the histo method, but still as a simplicity, we will see only these methods. For our, as per our requirement, we can get other parameters as well. So that's also about histograms. Thanks all. Thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel.